My name is Irving Herman. I'm in the Department of Applied Physics and Applied Math here in the School of Engineering and Applied Science. The name of the class that I teach to first year and second year students is Physics of the Human Body. And my research area is mostly in lasers and laser physics and materials and nanocrystals and nanomaterials. And several years ago, when the pre-professional course series started, I had wanted to do something in medical or bio-related areas, and I just said, let me teach physics of the human body. It was just like a spontaneous thing. And you know, I thought about how strong are bones. I said, how do you throw a baseball? How do you see? How do you hear? How do you speak? How does blood flow in your body? And I started thinking about all the things I wanted to learn myself. And so it's actually interesting because this is a class where students want to be in this class. And they enjoy taking it. And so that gives us better interaction between student and teacher than you normally have in classes that are required and, you know, maybe a little more advanced. And so one thing this course gives them is not only an understanding of a broader range of physical ideas and how to apply them and how that application is important and interesting, but it gives them a way of thinking about things, how to develop models, how to evaluate situations, how to look at what you need. And those are skills that you really need in all technical areas. And if you even think about it more broadly, even in non-technical areas, you have to not only learn material, you have to learn how to think and evaluate. And this is one thing that I try to address in the course.
My name is Jeff Noyan. I am a professor at Material Science and Engineering, which is part of Applied Physics and Mathematics. I will be teaching MSAE E1001, which is material science for the 21st century. Material science is a rather hybrid system. It is the basis of almost all modern technology. Everything we see around us is made out of materials. Some are natural materials. Most are man-made designed materials. Nowadays, we are getting to the point where we look at each and every atom we put into a system and tailor the atomic properties and then microstructural properties together to get a desired effect. I mean, that's essentially what we are trying to do. And I thought that I would do this as an example-based class. I'm going to look at two things. I'm going to try to teach people how to make a transistor very similar to the Bardeen and Shockley transistor of the early 50s. Then we'll go into sorts emitting. That's the second major part of it. In sorts emitting, we'll figure out how to make Damascus blades, the blades that actually the defenders used against the Crusaders with great effect. And the Crusaders were so impressed, they tried to duplicate them for a long time. And they could actually get blades that looked like that. There is a very famous water pattern in these microstructures in the steels. And they could get it by melding together two alloys, but they could never get them strong. Finally, after 500 years, people figured how to do it. And right now, there are a couple of swordsmiths who actually make true Damascus blades again. And once those are finished, I will discuss the future directions in material science. They will be nanomaterials, they will be metamaterials, they will be biomaterials. Essentially, what is the next revolution going to be about? There will be questions asked during the class in an ad hoc, almost Socratic discussion fashion, because that's what happens in an industrial setting. You know, you get together, you brainstorm. Essentially, it will be an introduction to what we make, how we make it from the material science, and having a huge amount of ancillary information that you can actually use in future discussions.